SCP-3165 is called Dog Teeth. It has a little bit more than dog teeth from what I saw in the thumbnail and the brief introduction. I mean, this thing looks like a were-dog or something like that. I don't know. We're gonna check it out today, guys. This one's by The Rubber. Make sure to subscribe to him. Subscribe to me if you like reaction videos, and let's get into this one.
Viewer discretion is advised. She woke up in a dark place. Okay. It smelled of rot and urine.
Ugh.
Before she could ascertain her location, Look. The half-wolf, half-human pressed up right in front
See?
Of her, examining intently with one side of its face.
All right.
A horrible sight with uncanny human features laid across a canvas
it's
of flesh.
It's like a werewolf.
She remembered.
But more
it
like
all
a
happened
canine?
So fast. The creature
I mean,
appeared out
like
of
a,
nowhere
a dog,
and killed her partner.
Not a wolf? Oh!
His neck was destroyed in a single bite. His torso torn apart.
So why not kill
but somehow,
her?
She was spared, but
yeah.
not for long.
Uh-oh.
As it grabbed her face, dug its claws into her flesh, and
oh.
peeled off the skin.
Oh!
Hello, everybody. I'm The Rubber.
I thought
Today,
she was
we bring
spare
you a SCP Foundation Euclid class
That's
object.
That's nasty. What happened to your face, girl? Dang.
SCP-3165, also known as Dog Teeth, is a humanoid female between
That's
the ages of 14 and 18,
okay.
with severe malformation in its limbs and
All
face.
Right.
It lacks body hair, and its skin is devoid of
it
pigmentation.
Is really,
the right
really
half
unsightly,
of 3165's face is obstructed by its upper and lower mandibles, which
okay.
resemble that of a wolf.
Right.
Its upper mandible lacks a nose, instead giving way to a soft crater where the nasal cavity has fleshed over. The bones of its feet are extended, and its
uh-huh.
hands are twice the length of an average adult human's.
I mean, it's like it turned into a werewolf.
That are also three times
is
more
what
durable.
It looks like.
Since the time of its
but
discovery, 3165's
like
left cornea
Shepherd.
Is milky white, suggesting late-stage cataracts.
All right.
3165 is incapable of producing human vocalizations.
But it
Therefore,
knows sign language?
It communicates through fractured sign language and certain beast-like guttural vocalizations.
All right.
3165 was discovered by a group of amateur paranormal investigator group in an undisclosed location
Can you
in
imagine?
Ukraine.
You Local go ghost hunting and you see something like that?
But unable to contain it, prompting the foundation to send out a recovery team.
We're not in Kansas
team.
Anymore, Dorothy.
The team arrived at the ruins. A faint smell of
ghosts?
Rotting bodies and feces permeated the
oh,
air.
Oh, gosh.
It gets more pungent as they navigated deeper into the
heart
of the
complex. I wouldn't be a ghost
hunter
just because of smells.
Throughout the exploration, they
Demons
came across various
like
items
sulfur,
littered
know?
On the ground.
Torn
clothes,
smell like poo
dried
urine.
Bones, unrecognizable biological masses, and
sure.
broken recording devices which can't be salvaged.
Victims. Victim
the team
stuff.
Arrived at a dead end. There, they found several objects, most notably a locket, which contained an image of a young blonde woman
so
which
she
was
changed
later identified
somehow.
As a missing
oh,
person
no, 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 no.
along
that was
with
one
her
of the missing
partner
people.
After
yeah,
a
yeah,
visit
yeah.
to Ukraine.
Okay.
Both individuals were then presumed to have been killed by 3165.
Right.
They have also found a face that has been separated and peeled away from the head.
That's
Rough
her face!
Cuts were observed around the eye sockets and mouth,
right.
suggesting the use of the skin as
oh
a mask.
Oh my god.
Soon enough, they started to hear a growl. 3165 was stalking them from the shadows
uh-huh.
and had them cornered where it wanted them to be.
Shoot him, Clint!
Suddenly, 3165 pounced on the leader. Its claw ripped through his throat with
oh,
ease. He was
god.
Killed instantly.
Well, yeah.
Panicked, the rest of the team immediately turned on their flashlights. 3165 was blinded for a moment and then pounced on its next target immediately.
Don't better do
In the
something.
Face of the onslaught, one of them fled the scene, leaving her alone. Her knees lost all strength. She fell to the
I
ground
guess.
As 3165 moved in closer to her.
He's going for your face, girl. Do
her
something.
Closely. Its claws reached for
Do
her
something.
Face and started to feel around her
so
cheeks and
So maybe it
hair.
Changed.
She could feel something sharp
yeah.
was digging into her skin. She tried to scream, but nothing came out of her.
Maybe it
Suddenly,
changed.
Suddenly, the wounded teammate jumped
into
on 3165
and now
jabbed
she's
a syringe full of ketamine onto its neck.
A face
Despite
for
being
wear
heavily injured, he wouldn't let go as 3165
that.
Flailed around and clawed at him in an awkward
God,
position.
God, the screaming!
Soon enough, the drug kicked in, and 3165 was immobilized.
Thank goodness.
His valiant effort paid off. But unfortunately, he died soon after
yeah.
due to severe blood loss.
Wow.
A backup team arrived, and 3165 was transported into containment before the drug wore off.
Sometimes you gotta make
According
some sacrifices.
According to the assessment of a child psychologist, 3165 possesses the mental capacity and behaviors of a human child of
okay.
roughly 6 to 7 years old, and
right.
is able to understand at least 200 words of the English language. 3165 appears to prefer direct communications with females. Interactions with male personnel were met with hostility, as shown in one incident when researcher Dr. Donald attempted to interview it. Entering the containment cell, he stopped his security details to wait outside.
And men's
but sir,
nicks.
The subject is highly volatile.
Yeah.
It injured and killed some of my men. The researcher merely let out a hearty laugh and waved in dismissal. That was because you lot went in with guns. We need to do this with love.
Oh,
the security head tried to interject, but the researcher turned towards the door before he could. Watch and learn, gentlemen. Watch and learn. The security head sighed and ordered his team to set up beside the door and be ready to rush in when things go south. Dr. Donald strode in and closed the door with a loud bang, startling 3165 from its slumber. He greeted it with a smile and then briskly sat in front of it. But his friendly gesture was not reciprocated. Instead, 3165 let out an intense growl and pounced on him. It clawed at his torso, breaking his ribcage, and bit off huge chunks of flesh in his right arm. Donald screamed as he clawed away from it, but 3165 wouldn't let him go. The security head called his team into action with immediate efficiency.
The screaming is actually hilarious, dude.
For Christ's sake. All right, get in there.
He told you so.
The team went in and shot 3165 with tranquilizer rounds. It let out a yelp and momentarily went limp
lost
on top of Dr. Donald.
Arm.
They gently pushed 3165 away from him, and Dr. Donald was carried out of the cell. By then, he had lost all consciousness.
Yeah, I guess
his
so. He got his arm ripped off.
Tore to the bone, dangling from his shoulder. It looked just as lively as Donald's expression with his dead eyes staring blankly through his broken glasses
and you thought he was
going to
do it with love?
Gaping mouth. And so,
that's
Dr.
what love
Warren,
gets you nowadays,
a female researcher, was assigned to the task. She entered the cell with an accompanying guard, and 3165 turned from its drawing to face Dr. Warren's. She smiled and approached 3165 with caution.
But she's got
it
a man with her.
At her lightly and nodded its head at her feet, indicating her to sit down. She sat. When Dr. Warrens asked how 3165 was feeling, it made the sign for pretty, then girl, and then pointed towards her.
You a pretty girl.
Dr.
I want
Warrens
your face.
Thanked 3165 and it squealed.
I
want to
take
glee.
Your face.
It then signed hair. And want towards Dr. Warren's. It stroked the side
She's
of its
just trying
head
to be
as it
pretty,
played
yo.
With its hair. Before Dr. Warren's
Get
could
a
assure
wig.
Her guard, 3165 suddenly jumped and scuttled up to her. Despite being shocked, Dr. Warren's stopped the guard from drawing his gun.
Just get her a wig, man.
Played around her hair.
Just get her
and
a little
Dr.
wig.
Dr. Warren's could feel that its claw was tugging at them lightly. Dr. Warren's then asked, "Why does it hurt people?" But it simply ignored her and continued to brush her hair.
Just wants to play with the hair.
Dr. Warren's slowly pulled herself away before it reaches another hand. At this point, its growl began to sound increasingly hostile.
Don't you take my hair away.
Her hair.
Yeah.
Want.
Get her a wig.
Girl.
Get her a wig.
Suddenly, it reached forward and braced Dr. Warren's face in its elongated hands. It drags its hands across her face as if measuring it and to carve it out. Its claws dug into her face and began to tear the skin. Dr. Warren's screamed and pushed 3165 away with all her strength. The guard immediately fired his taser at 3165. It let out a series of yelps and dropped to the floor.
Poor doggy just wants a wig, man.
From the shock. Dr. Warren's was escorted out of the cell.
Ouch.
When she looked back, 3165, with all its strength concentrated in one of its hands, weakly signed,
hair.
Pretty. Girl.
Pretty girl
what?
Hair.
A tear slowly dripped
from
its eye. Remember to check out.
Why? You know, why it had to be so sad? Just buy her a little weave. That's all she wants is some hair to play with, man. God. You know, man. Guys. Make sure to subscribe to the Rover. Subscribe to me if you like reaction videos too. Thanks so much for watching. As always, this is Zueljin signing off. We'll see you next time.